The DJI Air 2S is out with awesome options. Now the question is, will you be able to fly the drone under the new EU regulations? Eh bien, coming up.
Damn.
Bonjour my fellow high-tech fans, welcome back, bienvenue to my channel. The new drone from DJI is out, we are all excited about it. Some of you have bought it right away and some others want to know first if they can fly this drone in Europe following the EU regulations. Today we will talk about the drone and its specific options and of course we will see what we can and cannot do with it here in Europe. Let's get right into it. The camera of the drone has a 1-inch image sensor, which is larger than its predecessor and allows for better dynamic range in its footage. Everyone says it's better to have a 1-inch sensor, but do you know why? In the camera world, the bigger the sensor, the better the quality. A sensor is made up of millions of cavities called photosites. The number of photosites is the same number of pixels your camera has. So here, with the DJI Air 2S, we have 20 megapixels in a 1-inch sensor. A sensor with bigger pixels will collect more light and more light will generally improve image quality. The DJI Air 2S can capture up to 5.4K footage at 24, 25 and 30 frames per second from the full width of the sensor, and 4K up to 60 frames per second compared to Mavic Air's 4K at 30 frames per second, but with a slight crop. The DJI Air 2S also captures video at a higher 50 megabytes per second. Why do you need 5.4K? For better quality footage, and also if you want to zoom in on a subject, you can without damaging the quality of your shot. You can zoom in during video capture 4 times in 5.4K and up to 8 times in 1080p. The Air 2S is also serious about video colors with normal 8-bit, D-Log 10-bit and HLG 10-bit capture. Again, if this sounds Chinese to you or French, let me explain. Until the past couple of years, getting 10-bit on a mirrorless camera was nearly impossible. Today, we have several options like the Sony Alpha 7 S3 or the Panasonic GH5S. Cameras usually have 8-bit file, which works with RGB using 256 levels per channel, while 10-bit jumps up to 1024 levels per channel. This means a 10-bit image can display up to 1.07 billion colors, while an 8-bit photo can only display 16.7 million. Talking about its design, it is nearly identical to its predecessor and uses the same 3500 mAh battery. But the Air 2S is 25 grams heavier than its predecessor and as such has a reduced flight time estimate of 31 minutes, down from 33 minutes. The extra weight comes from the added two sensors on the front of the Air 2S. They enable something that DJI calls binocular zooming, which means the drone can see obstacles from farther and at higher speeds. If you're still here and enjoy my video, don't forget to like and subscribe so we can see each other more. Now, let's talk about the drone and the EU regulations. The new regulation distinguishes between low, medium, and high risk categories with different requirements for products and operators. The most widely used category for most of DJI's drone will be the open category, low risk, which will be managed through the so-called CE, Conformité Européenne, or in English, European Conformity. CE marking process, which is an established process for products sold in Europe to ensure they meet safety, health and environmental protection requirements. On all of DJI's drones, we can see the CE label. In addition to this already existing CE marking, the new CE class identification labels for drones will define, amongst others, which types of drone, categorized by weight, can be flown in which type of environment. For a transition period of 2 years until the 1st of January 2023, DJI customers with drones bought before the 1st of January 2021, which do not have a CE class identification label, can fly in the so-called open category with very little or any disadvantages, where the following rules apply. The DJI Air 2S doesn't have this CE class identification label. What does it mean? It means that from 2023, DJI drones without CE class identification labels can only be operated in the open limited category A1 if they weigh below 250 grams or A3 if they weigh between 250 grams and 25 kilos. And in the specific category. So it doesn't mean you cannot fly at all with your drone. You still need to follow the rules in this chart. For some, it can be annoying because limited to fields with nobody around, but for others, it's just fine. It all depends what you want to do with your drone. DJI cannot retroactively add a CE class identification label, but as soon as the EU regulations will be definitive in 2022, DJI will be able to post a list of drones that are following the EU requirements. So all in all, you should be fine with your new Air 2S drone. Don't forget to subscribe, les amis. Merci. Bisous. Take care. Salut.